Hi, I'm Ron Burgundy, here on G-Factor. I'm here with Nigel Thornberry. Nigel, where on the street is that you recently witnessed Bigfoot?
Yeah, well, me and my cousin Jack Gallett, we were just hanging out here on the porch, you know, making some beef jerky. We see Bigfoot, and I'm like, hey, is that Bigfoot? And apparently it was, because I found this, and, well, I don't know, what do you think I ought to do with it?
Well, since that's the only real evidence that you have, there's not really much evidence saying that it's actually real.
Are you saying I'm a liar?
That's just the word on the street. That's just what people are saying.
Well, you know what? Now I got no evidence, boy.
All right, sir. There's no need to get
I got
all.
No evidence.
There's no need to. Sir, please.
I got no
sir,
evidence.
Sir, please. Sir, wait.
What is
are
that?
Are you getting this? Are you
what
getting
is
this?
That?
Wait. What's going on?
What is it?
Is the camera rolling? Are you getting this? No, there's no way.
Hey, I think we might have ourselves a Bigfoot. We might have ourselves a Bigfoot. Very Bigfoot.
Nigel, it's reported that this is an actual footprint of the Sasquatch Bigfoot.
Yes, that'll be the truth of it.
And you were chasing him. How much did you happen to see of him?
I saw a whole lot of him.
Oh, did you?
There he is!
Oh,
yeah!
Oh my God, this is actually happening. This is Bigfoot.
Oh,
there's no way. Are you getting this? The camera rolling. Oh. Oh, he's gone. Be careful. He's gone. Oh. He actually looks like a real Bigfoot. All right. We'll be back after these commercials.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messing with Sasquatch.
Some beef jerky.
Good jerky.
Hey. You see that?
Come on.
Hey, buddy. You want some jerky?
Oh.
Some jerky?
Oh, we got you good. Here,
no,
come on.
You want it. No, you want it.
Oh. Oh. Come on.
Good jerky.
And we're back on G-Factor, here with Nigel. Nigel, what is this you have in your hand?
Well, this be the biggest tranquilizer in the east of Mississippi.
How powerful is this tranquilizer?
Well, I'll tell you what, every elephant in Africa will be dying by the night.
So where are you going to stick the tranquilizer?
Well, the tough place in the Bigfoot is the gluteus maximus, so...
So right now we're taking the Sasquatch to get analyzed by a professional scientist, and we're going to determine if he has characteristics of a living creature. I'm here with scientist Setter.
Hello.
Setter, we're going to test if this is a living creature. I have a few questions here, if you don't mind.
Well, yes, certainly.
All right. Is this made up of units called cells?
I do believe it is made up of units called cells.
All right, okay. Does it reproduce? And if so, how?
Yes, it does reproduce. I've seen baby Bigfoots in Texas, and they have been reported.
Okay. Is it based on a universal genetic code?
Yes, it is. It is actually a primate, like I said, in the mammal, mammal category. I do believe, but judging by the size of its feet and the opposing thumbs, that it is relatively close to us, despite the fact that it probably has 24 chromosomes, maybe, give or take.
Okay. Does it grow and develop?
Yes, it does grow and develop. I mean, judging by the size of it.
Okay. Does it respond to its environment?
Well, yes, it does, actually. It's been very, very reclusive. It's very hard to find one of these, and I don't know how you guys found this. I'm astound, actually. Yes, it does adapt to its surroundings by hiding. It camouflages, as you can tell, by its fur.
Does it maintain a stable internal environment?
Yes, it does. It's still breathing. It has relatively similar human characteristics, and as you can tell, its heart's still pumping and everything. I would say that it maintains an internal stable environment.
Okay. Does it change over time? As a species?
As a species, it does change over time. Based on pictures taken 50 years ago, it is obviously, judging by the fur and how well it is adapted into street clothes.
Probably,
I'm greatly surprised.
It probably has the fur to adapt to the cold winters, I would guess.
I would say so. It looks like the fur was,
this is made in China.
Anyway, what was the next question?
Does it obtain and use materials for energy?
It's a good thing you asked that, because right now we're going to do the autopsy.
Oh, is that where you cut open his stomach and see what he's going to eat?
Exactly.
All right, make sure you get this. Make sure you get this.
Okay, all right, ready? I'm going to grab my scalpel, of course, because we're going to do this very professionally. Okay. We're going to slowly rip open the hoodie.
Oh, he's cutting open Bigfoot's stomach.
Oh, wow. What? Oh, my God.
What is that?
What is that?
Is that... That's
a jack, Lane. Wait, oh, where's my boy? Wait, no, come back. I'm gonna die.
So he's gone now. The Bigfoot ran away.
Where is he?
We almost had him.
Almost had him?
I'm sorry. He got away.
So where is he?
He's a quick son of a gun.
We can still find him. There's still time. I'm Nigel!
Hi, I'm Ron Burgundy here on GFX. And we're back on G Factor. Here with Nick. And we're back on Hear Factor. How much tranquilizer is in this tranquilizer? So where are you gonna stick it?
Well, I say the toughest place for it would be, what is this thing? The Bigfoot.
So where are you gonna stick it? Right now, we're taking him to get analyzed. Hey, it's Golden.
How you doing?
Alright. Hey, you got that?